What's up, everyone? This is Craig, Weeping Willow Guitar Lessons. All right, I've got part two for Blue Sky for you here. In this lesson, we're going to take a look at the first guitar solo, or Duane's guitar solo from Blue Sky on the album Eat a Peach. All right, a couple things I want to mention before we get started. Number one, it's a long solo, a lot of notes. So instead of really going through each note meticulously, I'm kind of running through them. I figured with the notes on the screen, the notation on the screen, me walking through you, getting it under your fingers. I've got a full speed demo. I've got a slower demo for you. And then with the notation you can download from my blog, should give you everything you need to play this. The other thing I wanted to mention is, you know, watch this video to get the notes under your fingers, listen to my demos, but once you get it down, really go back and listen to the original to get the rhythm and the feel, because you can really only cop that from the record. And it's such a great feel, such a great solo, you really want to do that. All right, without further ado, grab your guitar and let's get started. Oh yeah, and don't forget to like this video, hit that subscribe button, and share this video. All right, thank you. All right, taking a look at Duane's guitar solo, the first guitar solo of Blue Sky on Eat a Peach. We're in the E major pentatonic scale up here in ninth position. But if it's easier for you to visualize the C sharp minor pentatonic scale, which they both share the same notes, that's fine. Just know that they function as an E major pentatonic scale because we're playing over an E chord, an E major chord, to an A major chord. And then we're having the inclusion of the A right here on the 10th fret of the second string. So that's going to be a shape you're going to see a lot in this solo. Alright, so I'm going to do these in two bar phrases for the most part. So we're going from an E chord to an A chord, and for the most part, Duane's phrasing is those two bars. Each phrase is kind of over those two bars. So we're starting off on the 11th fret of the third string with a whole step bend. Then we're going to release, pull off to the 9th fret, and then hit that bend again. Then we do that bend again, release, pull off to the 9th fret of the 3rd string. Then 11 and 9, pull off in the 3rd string. 11th fret of the 4th string. 9th fret of the 3rd string. Then we have 9, hammer on 11 on the 3rd string. Full step bend again. Then the 9th fret of the 3rd string. So three times in total. Then we have that 10, pull off 9 on the second string, A, pull off to G sharp. Then the 11th fret of the third string, 9th fret of the third string. So those first two bars sound like this. Alright, then we do that 11th fret whole step bend again twice. Followed by the bend, release, pull off to the 9th fret. Then we play the 9th fret again, and then two more times. Then 11-9, pull off in the 3rd string. 11th fret of the 4th string. Now this time we're going to go back to the 9th fret of the 3rd string, but we're going to slide down to the 6th fret of the 3rd string. That's the C sharp. We're playing the major third of the A chord now, and then the root of the A chord, 7th fret of the 4th string. So we play that A a total of 4 times. The 4th time, so 1, 2, 3, then the 4th time, we're sliding that up to the 11th fret. Again, a C sharp, then playing 9th fret to the 11th fret of the 3rd string. Alright, now we land on the 9th fret of the 3rd string. Then we're going to slide from the 11th fret to the 13th. And then play 12, 14 on the 2nd string. Then 12th fret of the 2nd string. Now we have the 14th fret, a step and a half bend. It's a minor third. And we hit that E. We release it and pull off to the 12th fret. Then we slide from the 13th fret of the 3rd string down to the 11th fret of the 3rd string. And land on that 9th fret again on the 3rd string. Then we hammer on 9 to 11 on the 3rd string, and make sure that's a staccato note. So you just play it and then don't let it ring anymore. Then the 9th fret of the 3rd string. And we play that 2 more times. Pull off from 11 to 9 on the 3rd string, then 11 to 9 on the 4th string. Alright, now we're going to play 9, hammer on 11 on the 4th string, and then 9 twice on the 3rd string. and we play that 9th fret 3 more times. And the third time, it's going to be part of this triplet figure. So we have... Alright, now we have another step and a half bend, minor third bend, starting on the 11th fret of the third string. We release that, then bend it again, a whole step, pull off to the 9th fret, then 11 to 9, pull off in the 3rd string, 11th fret of the 4th string, 9th fret of the 3rd string, and 9th fret of the 3rd string again, 11, 9. Alright, now we have the 11th fret, we bend up a whole step on the 3rd string twice. Then a quick bend or a pre-bend and release. 11th fret of the 4th, 9th fret of the 3rd. Then 9, hammer on 11 on the 3rd string. 9th fret of the 2nd string. 10, 9, pull off. Then 11th fret of the 3rd, 9th fret of the 3rd. Then another step and a half bend, followed by a full step bend. Pulled off to the 9th fret of the 3rd string, 11th fret of the 4th string, 9th fret of the 3rd string. Then we play the 9th fret of the 3rd string twice. Then we have 12th fret of the 1st string, pull off to the 9th fret of the 1st string. 12th fret of the 2nd string, 9th fret of the 2nd string. So as you can see, the majority of the solo, we're using the same notes, but he's just crafting them in these beautiful phrases, very melodic phrases. So he's getting a ton of mileage out of the same notes. All right, now on the 10th fret of the 2nd string, we play. So we're alternating between 10th fret and 9th fret, or the A and the G sharp, which would be the 4th and the major 3rd of an E chord. So that's 10, 9, 10, 9, 10, 9, then the 11th fret of the 3rd string, followed by the E, 9th fret of the 3rd string twice. Alright, now over the A chord, we're going to pull off that 10th to 9th fret of the A to G sharp on the 2nd string twice. Then 11 to 9 on the 3rd. 10th fret of the 2nd string. Then 9th fret of the 2nd string. 11th fret of the 3rd string. 9th fret of the 3rd. 11, 9. Those two measures together. We're going to bend the 11th fret of the 3rd string up twice again. Now this part's a little tricky. We release it, then we bend it up a full step, pull off to the 9th fret. Then we're going to do a minor 3rd or a step and a half bend, followed by a full step bend. So we have... Then 9th fret of the 3rd, 11th fret of the 4th, 9th fret of the 3rd. Alright, over the A chord then, we're going to pull off from 11 to 9. So notice that 9th fret is held over, the E is held over for the first 16th note of the A chord. And then we do our pull off. So we have... So pull off 11 to 9 in the 3rd, 11th of the 4th, 9th fret of the 3rd. Then 9th fret of the 3rd again, now we have our... A to G sharp pull off, or 10th and 9th fret on the 2nd string, 11 to 9 on the 3rd, then 9, 11, 9. Alright, now we're going to move up into the 12th position. So we're going to slide from the 11th fret of the 3rd string up to the 13th fret of the 3rd string, landing on our G sharp of our E chord, or our major 3rd. Then we have the B, or 5th of an E chord, 12th fret of the 2nd string. Then we're gonna bend the 14th fret of the first string, F sharp, up a whole step to G sharp, which is our major third on the E chord. Release it. Pull off to the 12th fret, 14-12 on the second string. Then we land on the 12th fret on that next measure. So we have. Then we hammer on 12 to 14, then 12, then pull off 14 to 12. Quick grace note slide from the 13th to the 11th fret on the third string. And then the next measure, we're landing on the E, 9th fret of the third string. So we have. Next measure, we start on this 9th fret, the E, and we play that twice. Then 11 to 9 pull off, 11th fret of the 4th string, 9th fret twice on the 3rd string. Then 9 twice, 11 9, and then 10 9 on the 2nd string. So we have. Alright, now we have 9, 10, pull off to 9 on the 2nd string, then 9, 10, 12, 10, 9, 10, then 9, 11th on the 3rd string, 9th on the 2nd, so we have. Then we're going to go down to the 3rd string and play 11, 9, 11. So that's still in that same phrase. So starting on measure 44, we have. All right, a little slower. Play the 9th fret 3 times, and then slide down to the 6th fret of the 3rd string, our C sharp, followed by our A, 7th fret of the 4th string. Notice though, we're still over an E chord, so we have. Now, over the A chord, we're going to slide up from 9 to 11, then 9 twice on the 3rd string, 11 pull off 9, 11th fret of the 4th string, followed by the 9th fret of the 3rd string, then that 9th fret 2 more times. Now we're going to move up to 12th position again, sliding from the 11th fret of the 3rd string to the 13th fret of the 3rd string, 12, 14 on the 2nd, 13 on the 3rd. So we have. Alright, now 12th fret on the 2nd string. We're on our 5th of an E chord, B. So we play that once, two more times, then we're gonna play 12, 14, hammer on, pull off to 12. So we have 13th fret of the 3rd string, then 12 again on the 2nd, two more times, then two more times. So altogether that measure sounds like this. Then we're going to slide from the 14th fret up to the 17th fret, and that's an E, and then we're going to work out of this kind of E sus4 shape. So we have our E triad and then the suspended fourth on the 17th fret of the first string. So if you picture that shape, we have. Then we we play the 17th fret of the second string again. 17 pull off 16 on the first. 17th on the second. Then 16th, and we're getting ready to hammer on to the 19th. All right, so these next two measures are kind of the trickiest measures in Duane's solo, in my opinion. So we, especially at the full speed of the song, because it gets quite fast. So we introduce some 32nd notes, and we get this kind of 3/4 feel, and it sounds like this. So it moves between this E major triad and then this E add 4 triad. So we have the 17th fret of the second string, 16th fret of the first string, and 19th fret of the first string. That's our E triad. Then the 17th fret of the second string, 16th fret of the first string, 17th fret of the first string. And that's kind of our E add 4 triad. So we switch between that and we have. So we're pulling off from the 19th to the 16th fret of the first string, then playing the 17th fret of the second string. Then going back up to the 16th fret of the first string, hammering onto the 17th fret, pulling back off to the 16th. Then the 17th fret of the second string. Then we go back up to the 16th fret of the first string and hammer on the 19th fret to start that over. So we have. So if you take this series of notes and count that as one, if you play that 4 times, that's what we need to do. And then we're going to play the 17th fret of the second string, 16th fret of the first string, 17th fret. Again, pull off to the 16th fret of the first string, then the 17th fret twice on the second string. And now we're going to start a series of sliding down. So we start on the 17th fret of the second string, slide down to the 16th fret, then play that 2 more times, then 1 more, and slide down. So. So notice we're playing the D sharp right out of the E major scale. So when we slide down, we're sliding from 17th to 16th, then playing that a total of 3 more times, and on the third time sliding down, same with the 12th fret. Third time we play it, we slide down to the 10th fret. Then we play that, and then the third time, instead of sliding, we pull off to the 9th fret, then 11-9 on the 3rd string. Then we have 10 pull off 9, or A, pull off to the G sharp on the 2nd string, 11-9 on the 3rd, 9 hammer on 11 on the 3rd, 9, 10 pull off on the 2nd, 11th fret to 9th on the 3rd, then 3 more times. So those two measures sound like this. Alright, then over the E chord, our measure 54, we have. So there, we're pulling off 12 to 9 on the first string, then 12, 10, 9 on the second string, and 11, 9 on the third. Then 9 to the 11th on the 3rd, 9, 10 on the 2nd, 12, pull off 9 on the 2nd. Then we're going to slide that 12th, or bend that 12th fret of the 2nd string up a whole step. Then we bend it again, release and pull off to the 9th fret of the 2nd string, bend it again. Then we're going to bend the 11th fret of the 3rd string up a whole step. Again, release and pull off to the 9th fret. Then we have 11th fret of the 4th, 9th of the 3rd, 11th of the 4th. Now we're into the beginning of the harmony parts, and we already went over this in the Blue Sky Part 1 lesson, so I'm not going to really get into detail on this. I'm just going to play it through. This is where Dickie picks up his solo. All right, I hope you enjoyed this lesson as much as I have. Join me next time for the 3rd and final part, and we'll be taking a look at the 2nd guitar solo, Dickie's guitar solo. All right, see you next time.